Welcome back, guys. This is Matthew Doyle here at Scaleform. We'll be continuing our overview of the new GFX 3.1 HUD Kit. In this segment, we'll cover the files involved in creating the HUD Kit and provide a brief look into the main flash file. There are essentially three elements to the HUD Kit: the flash files, the C++ code specific to the HUD Kit, and the simulation. This simulation would obviously be replaced by your game code. Let's take a look at how the HUD Kit communicates with the game. The HUD Kit uses the adapter design pattern. This allows the developer to reuse the HUD Kit without significant modification to the game code. We recommend you modify our sample wrapper, but you could easily create your own and simply refer to ours for examples. We'll find the HUD Kit files in the Scaleform installation under Apps, Kits, HUD. In the common directory, we'll find the main C++ files for updating the HUD. The key file here is fxhudview.cpp. This file provides the implementation of types defined in fxhudview.h and fxhudkit.h, including the logic for the log and billboard system. We'll also find the files for updating the minimap here. The minimap C++ code is contained in its own class, fxminimapview, due to its complexity. In the HUD demo folder, we'll find the demo simulation files as well as the wrapper files. HUD adapter is the adapter implementation. It decouples the simulation from the HUD to allow for convenient reusability. HUD Kit demo is the core application which puts it all together. It's built on top of the standard FX player. HUD simulation creates a demo environment for the simulation, containing players from two teams in a capture the flag game. HUD Entity Controller is used to update simulation logic and AI. You'll find the flash files in the Scaleform installation under Bin, Kits, HUD. There are two flash files in the kit. HUDKit.fla is the main file, and MinimapFLA contains the minimap. HUDKit contains all the UI elements and actually loads the minimap.swift element at runtime. The ActionScript code for this can be found on frame 1 of HUD Kit. We'll take a closer look at that code in just a minute. While animations in GFX can be handled in one of three ways, C++, ActionScript, or the Flash Timeline, in this demo, the majority of the HUD animations are handled on the timeline. This allows a UI artist or UI designer to easily create and manage the HUD graphics with very little need to get the UI programmer involved. Let's have a quick look at the HUD Kit flash file. As you can see, there's very little ActionScript in this file. The core HUD updates are handled by C++, providing a much faster implementation. Starting from the top, we have a block of code that loads the minimap at runtime. This next block of code has to do with where the performance data is displayed. One of the most important lines of ActionScript in the file is found next. This external interface call in frame 1 is necessary to pass a pointer to the movie clip, which C++ can register with the HUDView C++ file, which can then use that pointer to manipulate the UI. Next, we have some code related to the display of the AI billboards. Although the game is a 2D simulation, the billboards are drawn to appear as if they were being rendered in a 3D environment. Following this is a chunk of code dedicated to adjusting the HUD element locations based upon the resolution of the screen. Every individual piece of the interface has an instance name. These instance names are critical as they are used to create references via the Direct Access API in the C++ HUDView file. For instance, clicking on the Team Stats layer, then selecting the movie clip on stage, we can see that this movie clip has an instance name of Team Stats. Double-click this movie clip to enter its timeline. We can see that inside the Team Stats movie clip are several other items related to this particular interface element. Clicking on each one, we can see that they have appropriate instance names. Keep in mind that these instance names are used in C++ to create more intuitive references via the Direct Access API. In the next video, we'll briefly go over the core functions inside the FX HUDView source code file.